What is happening, guys? This is Rob of Rule of Two Review. Welcome back to the channel, and today we're talking more Legend of Zelda. So we live in pretty exciting times, man, because we live in a time where there are two official and confirmed Legend of Zelda titles being worked on right now to release sometime in the future. Of course, the big thing right now is the fact that at E3 a couple of weeks ago, Nintendo confirmed the sequel to Breath of the Wild, the actual direct sequel, which is crazy and mind-blowing and so exciting. And then, we also know later this year in September, we're going to get the remake of The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening. Now, I already spent like 23 or 24 minutes in a video talking to you guys about Breath of the Wild 2 and my massive excitement for it, some of my theories and predictions for the game based on the trailer, and some of my wishes and the things that I hope to see included in the game. But Link's Awakening is kind of this like sneaky little extra title that's coming out later this year that does have some attention, but doesn't seem to have enough attention. I mean, it really doesn't seem to be the game that a lot of people are focused on this year. And, you know, I don't think that it's necessarily a shame, but I do wish that more people were paying attention to it. And in fact, once I finished making my Breath of the Wild 2 video a couple weeks ago, I realized I really needed to discuss Link's Awakening as well, because this game is really exciting to me. Not only just because, hey, it's a new Zelda game and that's always cool, but as you guys have heard me say a few times, Zelda Link's Awakening is one of the very few Zelda games I've never played. It's all handheld games. I've never played Link's Awakening, and the two Oracle games, Oracle of Ages and Oracle of Seasons, I've unfortunately never played those either. And I regret that. I wish that I had played all of these games. In fact, one of my best friends for a long time, his favorite game of all time is Link's Awakening. So I've always known about this game and the Windfish and like Yoshi and Mario and like a Chain Chomp are included in it, right? And all of these weird kind of things and quirks that are just in this random strange Zelda game. And I've also always known the game to be really great. So obviously the main reason that I'm so excited for it is just because it is effectively going to be a brand new Zelda game to me. And I love the fact that they've given such a modern update to this game. I cannot get enough of the graphical style, you guys. It floors me every time I see it. This game is so damned beautiful, I don't even know what to do with myself. And to me, it's very reminiscent of what Nintendo did with Metroid: Samus Returns. Whereas that was a remake of a Game Boy game, and a remake to the degree that I've considered it many times to be effectively just a brand new game. Like, yes, it's Metroid 2, you're hunting down 40 Metroids and you're fighting the Metroid Queen and yada yada, so that core concept is the same, but taking that old, like, 1989, maybe 1990, I feel bad, I can't remember the release year of Metroid 2, but taking that old Game Boy game and redoing it to the degree Samus Returns was really just entirely brand new. The map wasn't that familiar to the original game. Some of it was, but for the most part, it wasn't. And it looked incredible. And it seems like that's exactly what's happening with Link's Awakening. They're taking a classic Game Boy old school game in this Zelda franchise and now giving it the same remake where from the ground up, they've changed so much about it, it seems like it's going to be just a new game in general. Like I said, it's already going to feel like a new game to me, but I imagine for even longtime fans, they're going to feel like it's also a new game, maybe other than some of the obvious big plot points that have to carry you through the same story of the original release. It's going to be pretty sweet. I tried to watch some of the Treehouse footage, and it was really fantastic during E3, but I also didn't want to see too much of the game. So I watched about half of one of their main demonstrations, and they also did spend a lot of time on that dungeon creator mode, that thing that you do with Dompei from Ocarina of Time, who now is showing up in this game to give you like a dungeon mix and match sort of thing, which is pretty cool. It's not something I'm like super excited for myself, because it seems like it's just an extra mode they add to add some longevity and replayability to the game, and I think it's fine for that, but it's not what I'm going in for, man. I'm going in for the meat of the experience, which is to experience the story, this version and this map of Hyrule, and to just kind of play through this world and enjoy being in this Hyrule world. And, you know, I'm somebody who's also a huge fan of A Link Between Worlds, which, of course, was on the 3DS, the direct sequel to A Link to the Past, which was phenomenal, and I loved what they did with that game. They took literally, it was like 95% the exact same map from A Link to the Past, added some tweaks, and just made new dungeons, new enemies, weapons, graphics, and then, of course, that wall mechanic where you could turn into, like, a painting on a wall and move around the world, and it was incredible. And they're obviously doing a lot of that here with Link's Awakening and adding some new weapons and power-ups and just new areas. I mean, it really is just going to be amazing. Now, I've also voiced my one concern with this game before, and it's if this game turns out to be too short or too easy. And I don't really want it to be either of those. I think that we effectively know this game is going to be charged full price at $60. I don't know if that's been confirmed yet, but it's what most of us assume. And there was a conversation when it was first revealed on if that would be too much money. And I've heard a lot of people, including some big name people, like some of the guys at IGN, for example, say that they feel this game shouldn't be full price and it should only be about $40. And, you know, for me, I'm willing to pay $60 for this game, even if it is short. But hearing people who are probably more familiar with the original release say that this game, even with the overhaul, should only be charged for $40 is a little bit worrisome, because my assumption is that people who already know this game already assume it to be a short and easy experience. And so they must be thinking, man, if you take a game as small and simple as Link's Awakening and release it today, in a modern day, that game is not worth a full $60 price. It's too short. There's not enough substance to the game to warrant a $60 price. And if people are thinking that, and that's why they're sharing that opinion, that makes me nervous, because I want this game to be something that has enough content and substance to be worthy of the full $60 I'm going to pay for this game. I want a long adventure. I want a lot of story. I want a lot of, I don't know if side quests can be part of a game like this or not, but I'd love to see side quests, lots of areas to traverse. I'd like to get lost in the world, just kind of running around, finding secrets and stuff, while also having dungeons to go through, weapons to get, people to talk to, and bosses to fight. I really want that perfect mix, man, which is what most of the Zelda games have been doing for the last 15 or 20 years or so now. So I want to believe that Nintendo will throw a lot of that extra stuff in there because they're remaking it and because they seem to be changing and adding so much to the game. But, you know, I have to be realistic to myself and know that that might not be the case. Maybe Nintendo is going bare bones, so to speak, with only a few extra mechanics built in and mostly being the same game, only with a prettier graphics engine. And that still won't be super disappointing, because it will be my first time. But I would love it if this was something worthy of a Link to the Past kind of scale. That's just this huge, sprawling adventure. And so, you know, this is where I'd have to rely on a lot of you guys out there who already have played Link's Awakening on the Game Boy to tell me, yes, there is enough substance in that game to warrant this game being full price, or no, it's too short and too simple to warrant being full price. This game should be $40 because there just isn't enough to do in that game. And so if you guys tell me that, it'll kind of help it put in perspective for me, because, you know, whereas I feel like I am otherwise a Zelda expert and have played all the main games, all the NES, the Super NES, you know, GameCube, 64, everything. I've played everything but literally those three Game Boy games. This is the one area where it's like I have a void of knowledge. I'm just not familiar with this title. So I have to play ignorant and just be honest with you guys and say I don't know what to expect. All I can say is I love the visuals. I love what they're showing here. I love what I did watch from the treehouse. So I have very high expectations for this game. So I think for the most part, that's what I have to say on Zelda today. That's the Zelda talk for the weekend here. Link's Awakening. Looks great, very excited, hoping it's not too simple and easy, but I'm still gonna hope for the best. I'm very optimistic. And you know, even if this game does turn out to be short and easy, I still trust this game to be an absolute blast to play. Nintendo just really doesn't mess up Zelda, you know? I love even the games that are most controversial. I love Skyward Sword, I think that that's a great game. I love Twilight Princess, like, they're all good to me. I love Zelda 2 The Adventure of Link, I've said many times. I will defend that game to the death, so it's probably going to be pretty easy to please me, if we're being honest. Like, I'm not that harsh of a critic when it comes to franchises I already enjoy. So, I'm expecting good things, but I don't know, man. What do you guys think? How excited for this game are you? Are you over the moon pumped like I am? Are you a little bit nervous and have some trepidation? Or do you just simply not care, and maybe you even hated the original release, so you couldn't care about this release? I mean, whatever you feel, talk about it below. And with that, this video is a wrap. Thanks, of course, as always, for tuning in, guys. This is Rob of Rule of Two Review, and I'll catch you next time on another video.